Hello and welcome again to this particular session. And now we are moving over to section 6, as you can see flashing on your screens. Correct, section 6. While leaving the last session, I did talk about this particular section, that from this particular section, generally in the examination, you are asked 2, 3, or 4 mark questions and you are supposed to pass adjustment entries. For example, this question is of hardly 2 marks, 6.1. Alpha company having head office in Mumbai has a branch at Nagpur. The branch at Nagpur is an independent branch, and on 31st of 3 2017, it was found that goods dispatched by the head office 2 lakh was received by the branch only to the extent of 1,50,000. So out of 2 lakh worth of goods, 1,50,000 worth of goods have been received. That means 50,000 worth of goods haven't been received. It means these goods are still in transit. I have sent you 2 lakh worth of goods. You have received 150. That means 50,000 worth of goods are still in transit. It means these goods haven't been yet received by branch. So what branch will have to do? Branch will have to pass a simple entry, goods in transit account debit to head office account. It is very simple. This type of entry we did. Then 6.2, question 6.2, straight stat. Give general entries in the books of branch 1. This time head office might be having, let us say, more than one branches. Let us say one is branch office 1 and another one is branch office 2. And question is asking you to prepare what we call past general entries in the books of branch 1 only to rectify the following. The first one is head office expenses, ₹3,500 allocated to branch but not recorded in the books of branch office. So these expenses have been allocated to the branch but not recorded in the books of branch still. So now branch will pass this entry, profit and loss account debit, to head office account, because now these expenses will have to be borne by branch and this much of amount branch will have to pay to the head office. So that is why entry is profit and loss account debit to head office account. I have written 3,500 because we have done already questions. In the earlier section, such questions we have already done. Depreciation of branch assets. Now, depreciation of branch assets, whose accounts are kept by head office, not provided by the branch office. Now, there is depreciation on some fixed asset, and fixed accounting of fixed asset is being done by what we call head office, while fixed assets are being used by the branch. So because now branch will have to pass the entry, so branch will incur a loss because now this depreciation will fall upon branch, so its profit and loss account will reduce, and this much of amount branch must provide to head office. So profit and loss account debit, or you can write in bracket depreciation also. This is what I have written here, depreciation or profit and loss account debit to head office account. Branch office paid 2000 as salary to inspector, but the amount paid has been debited by branch office to the salary account. Now branch office paid 2000 as salary to the head office inspector. Important point is that this is your head office, this is your branch. Head office might have sent one inspector for some inspection work. So inspector was dispatched from head office to inspect the proceedings of the branch. This what happens in practical life. Generally, head office have some personnel in the form of inspector, supervisor, etc. They keep on sending it to various branches to see to it that how branches are functioning, or whether they are functioning according to what we call our expectations or not. Correct? So logically, the salary of this inspector should have been met by the head office, not by the branch. Now what happened? Branch office paid 2000 as salary to the inspector. First of all, in this case, what happened? We paid salary to the head office inspector. Head office inspector account debit to bank account. Actually, branch paid salary to head office inspector. So we paid salary account debit to bank account. Correct? We paid the salary to the head office inspector, but the amount has been debited by branch office to salary account. So we have debited this account to salary account. But point here is that this salary which we paid to branch to head office inspector should we should not have had paid it. That means this expense was of head office and was not of branch. So now what branch will do? Because when branch paid salary, so branch must have written this entry, and ultimately this salary must have been debited to profit and loss account. So logically, due to payment of salary to the head office inspector, unnecessarily the profit and loss account of the branch has been debited. So now what branch will do in order to rectify it? Because its profit has fallen, it will credit it back, and branch will recover this amount from the head office. So branch will pass this entry, head office account debit to profit and loss account. You can write in bracket salary also if you want to. So head office account debit to salary account, this is the entry I have written over here. Similarly, point number 5, a remittance of 15,000 sent by branch office has not been received by head office. So branch office has already sent 15,000 worth of amount. Now no entry for this transaction, but before that there is point number 4 also. Let me go through that. Head office collected rupees 10,000 directly from a customer on behalf of the branch office, but no intimation to this effect has been received by the branch. Actually, there was a customer of the branch. Branch must have sold some goods to a customer on credit. So customer should have had paid to the branch. Correct? Because it was customer of the branch. But what this customer did actually, this customer paid the amount to the head office. So head office received unnecessarily a amount which was supposed to be received by the branch. So now what branch will do? See here, if branch would have received the amount, the entry would have been cash account debit to customer account. Because if we would have had received the amount from the customer, that is branch, then branch would have debited the cash or bank account and credited the customer account, because customer has paid. So balance of customer must get reduced. So we must credit it. But problem is that this cash is not received by us. This has been received by head office. So branch will now pass an entry, head office account debit to customer account. Branch will reduce the customer balance, but this amount which was not received by branch, branch will recover it from head office. That is why it will debit the head office. That is why your entry is head office account debit to debtors or customer account. Correct? Now, a remittance of 15,000 sent by branch office has not been received by the head office. Now, no entry will be passed in the books of the branch because branch has already done the entry. Of course, head office will do the entry, cash in transit account debit to branch account. Branch 1 incurred advertisement expense of 3,000 on behalf of branch 2. Actually, we are branch 1 account, and we incurred some advertisement expenditure. But this advertisement expenditure was on behalf of branch 2. So when we incurred this expense, we means branch office 1, we must have passed this entry at that time, isn't it or not? However, this expense which we incurred was supposed to be incurred by head office, because we incurred the expense on behalf of branch 2. That doesn't mean that this particular expense should have been borne by branch 2. It was the duty of the head office to take care of branch 2's expense. So anyway, we incurred an expense which was supposed to be incurred by actually the head office, not by branch 2. Remember one thing. So when we incurred this expense, our profit must have got reduced. So in order to rectify the same, we will write profit and loss account debit, and we will recover this amount from head office. So you will write this entry. It is not written over here. You can write entry number 6, and there is no entry for fifth number. So you will debit the head office account and you will credit your profit and loss account. 6.3 is pretty easy. 6.3 is very easy. There is nothing for me to discuss in it. I've already told you simple questions you will be asked from this particular topic. Correct? Just give me a second. Now, as far as 6.3 is concerned, in this question, it is written that goods worth rupees 50,000 sent by head office, but the branch has received till the closing date goods only to the extent of 40,000. That means 10,000 worth of goods are still in transit. So, your entry will be goods in the books of branch, your entry will be goods in transit account debit to head office account. Out of 50,000, 40,000 worth of goods you have already received. So 10,000 worth of goods you will receive now. And these goods are still in transit. 6.4. In this case, it is written that Global Limited has branch which closes its books of account every year on 31st of March. This is an independent branch which maintains comprehensive books of accounts for recording their transactions. Give journal entries in the books of the branch on 31st 3 2021 or whatever date it is written to rectify the following. Correct? So in the books of branch we have to pass the entry. In the books of the branch we have to pass the entry, and the first one is head office expenses 135,000 allocated to branch but not recorded in the books of branch. So head office has what we call allocated 135,000 worth of expenses to branch. So profit and loss account of branch will now get reduced, and this much of amount branch must pay to the head office. So this will be the entry 135,000. Depreciation of branch assets whose accounts are kept by head office are not provided by the branch. Now, so many times we have done this particular entry because depreciation has been provided by now head office, and it was responsibility to of the branch to bear this expense. So branch will now debit its profit and loss account and pay back to head office the amount of depreciation. Entry will be profit or loss to head office. Branch office paid 140,000 as salary to the head office inspector. But the amount has been debited by branch office to salary account. Branch paid an expense in the form of salary. Because branch paid the salary, the profit or loss account of branch must have got reduced, correct? And it must have paid the amount. So this was the entry you can say branch has already made. So in order to rectify this entry, in order to rectify this entry, what branch will now do? What branch will do, now do? It will recover the amount from the head office, and when it will recover, its profit and loss account will increase. So head office account debit to profit and loss account. Similar to the last one, 130,000 directly from a customer were collected by head office. Because customer has paid, so branch must credit the customer account. Branch must credit the customer account. However, branch did not receive the cash. Cash has been received by head office, so branch will debit the head office account to recover that cash. A remittance of 150,000 sent by branch has not been received by the head office. No entry for this in the books of branch because branch must have passed the entry already. Branch incurred advertisement of 30,000 on behalf of branch B. Because our branch has incurred the expenses, so our profit or loss account must have got reduced. So, in order to rectify the same, we will credit the profit or loss account and we will recover the expenses which we have incurred from head office. So, head office account debit to profit or loss account, entry number 6. This is how you are going to pass the entry. You will not write cash account, you will write here debit, profit or loss. Head office account debit to profit and loss account. Six point five. What does this question states? give journal entries in the books of head office. Now, in this question, actually, entries in the books of head office have been asked. So, in this question, goods sent to branch 12,000 and is stolen during the transit, branch manager refused to accept any liability. Because some loss of goods have been taken place, see, head office sends goods to branch. How head office sends goods to branch? First of all, head office will have to purchase those goods. Are you getting my point or not? When head office will purchase the goods for the purpose of sending through various branches, head office must have passed this entry, purchases account, debit to bank account. Whenever head office will purchase the goods. Correct? Now, out of these purchases, some goods must have been sent to branch. So at that time, head office must have written the entry, branch office account, debit to goods sent to branch account. Correct? But in between, some loss has taken place. The question says that stock is stolen. So loss by theft account debit or stock is stolen account debit. So now head office will pass this entry, loss by theft account debit to purchases account, because we have purchased the goods and sent to branch, so our purchases will get reduced. So that is why we will have to pass this entry. This is the entry which we will have to pass in this particular case. Loss by theft account debit to purchases account. Is it clear to you? In the books of head office I am talking about. Branch paid 15,000 as salary to the officer of head office on his visit to the branch. This is similar to the head office inspector case. This time what is happening? Branch office is paying some expenses. So profit or loss account of branch must have reduced because branch paid salaries, and this salary was paid to a person which was appointed by the head office. How I am saying so? Because it is written branch paid 15,000 as salary to the officer of the head office. He is officer of the head office. Branch is not supposed to pay him, but branch paid it. So on account of this, what happened? Profit or loss account of branch got reduced. So now what branch will do? Branch will try to recover this amount from the head office. So when branch will recover this amount, branch will pass this entry, and head office will pass this entry. Because head office is now supposed to pay to the branch. Sorry. Head office is now supposed to pay to the branch. So profit or loss account of head office will get reduced, and head office is supposed to pay to the branch, so branch office account will be credited. Is it clear to you or not? This is the entry, profit or loss account debit to branch office account. So debit salary account, instead of salary you write profit or loss account to branch account. Is it clear to you or not? This is the entry head office will pass. Point number 3, on 28th of March 2019, head office dispatched goods to branch. Because head office has dispatched the goods, head office has already passed the entry. Branch will have to pass the entry, goods in transit account debit to head office. That's a different matter. But head office will not pass any entry. That is why no entry is written over here. A remittance of 10,000 sent by branch to the head office, not received by it. Now, in this case, branch will not pass the entry, but head office will pass the entry, cash in transit account debit to branch account. That is fine. Point number 5, head office made payment of 25,000 for purchase of goods by branch, wrongly debited to its own purchases account. Actually, what happened? Head office this time made some payment for the purchases made by branch. Head office made the payment. So head office now will try to recover those payments from the branch. So So head office will debit the branch office account because they are independent branches. So logically, purchases is made by branch. Branch was supposed to pay for the same. It is not a case of dependent branches. So that is why head office will debit branch office account. But problem is that head office unnecessarily debited its purchases account. So in order to rectify that, it will now credit the purchases account. So this is how head office is going to pass the entry for this branch account debit to purchases account. Is it clear to you? Now, just wait. Now 6.6, as far as 6.6 is concerned, in this question, it is given give journal entries in the books of head office. Once again, the entries have been asked in the books of head office. Depreciation amounting to 11,000 on branch fixed assets when such accounts are maintained in the books of head office. Correct? Actually, so many times we have confronted this particular transaction and we have seen that in the books of branch, branch will pass the entry profit and loss account debit to head office. Reason being is that depreciation has been provided by branch. So head office will have to pay to the head office for the same and it will be a loss to branch because depreciation expenses are there because it was the duty of the branch to bear these expenses, but head office bore those expenses. So branch will pass this entry, while head office will pass this entry, branch account debit to branch fixed asset account. Why? Because head office is incurring the expense, but these expenses, head office is supposed to recover back from the branch. And when depreciation will be provided, you can write in bracket depreciation also if you want. And when depreciation will be provided, the fixed asset account, which is being maintained by what we call in this case head office, will get reduced. So we will have to credit the branch fixed asset account. Goods amounting to 7,500 transferred from city F branch to city G branch. Whenever, actually this time head office might be having two branches. One is in city F and another one is in city G. So head office might have asked branch F to transfer some goods to what we call city G. So goods amounting to 7,500 transferred to city G. So head office will pass the entry city G branch account debit to city F branch account. Because logically to city G branch, it was the duty of the head office to send them some goods. But instead of sending the goods by themselves, that is head office asked city F to send the goods. So city G branch account is debited, but now head office will have to pay to city F branch for the amount of goods which they have supplied to city F. City G branch paid 2,10,000 for machinery purchased by head office. Now machinery is purchased by head office. So head office will debit the machinery account. But payment was not paid by head office. If head office would have had paid the amount, then head office would have had written to bank. But now it will write to branch city G account because city G actually paid this amount. So that means head office is supposed to pay to city G account. That is why machinery account debit to city G account will be the entry. Similarly, fourth one, branch in city F collected 8,000 from a city F customer of the head office. Branch in city F collected 8,000 from city F customer of the head office. Now this time customer is of head office. This time customer is of head office. So if head office would have collected, head office would have written the entry cash account debit to debtors account. But this amount was collected by city F branch. City F branch. So head office will now debit city F branch account because now head office will recover the amount from city F. Goods 20,000 sent by head office to branch in city G on 28th of March and received by the branch after later on 10th of April, that been in the next year. Important point is that these goods which have been sent by the head office were not received by the branch till the end of the current year. So quite obviously, head office is not going to pass any entry for this because head office has sent the goods. Already entry is passed. However, city G account will pass the entry, goods in transit account debit to head office account. Correct? Similarly, there is 6.7. In this case, entry is to be written in the books of head office once again. Correct? Goods purchased by branch 7,500, but payment made by head office. Now see, these are independent branches. If goods are purchased by the branch, branch was supposed to make the payment and head office made the payment. So head office will debit the branch account. Head office has wrongly debited this account to its own purchases account. Problem is that when head office made the payment, it debited, it wrote the entry purchases account debit to bank. That means it unnecessarily debited the purchases account. So that is why purchases account will have to be credited to actually rectify the entry. Branch paid 6,500 as salary to a visiting head office official. Because branch has paid the salary, branch has paid the salary, correct? This salary was supposed to be paid by the branch. Branch paid the salary to a visiting head office official. Branch has debited the amount to the salary account. Now, branch will make an entry, that's a different matter, but what head office will pass the entry? This expense now will have to be borne by head office. So head office will debit its profit and loss account. You can write in bracket salary, correct? And it will credit the branch account because head office is now supposed to pay to the branch for this 6,500. Depreciation 11,250 in respect of branch shop whose account is kept in the books of head office. So actually head office is maintaining this shop, keeping the accounts of this shop. Head office will provide the depreciation. When head office will provide the depreciation, its profit and loss account will reduce. Correct? And of course the branch shop account balance will also reduce when we will provide the depreciation. However, this depreciation which we are providing actually was supposed to be provided by the branch. So that is why head office will now pass the entry branch office account debit to branch shop account. Is it clear to you or not? Branch account debit to branch shop account. Expenses 5,600 charged to branch for work done on behalf of the head office. On its behalf by the head office. Actually, head office has done some work on behalf of the branch. So we have to receive from the branch 5,600 and instead of writing expenses, you better write profit or loss account, write expenses in bracket. Correct? Because branch has done some work on behalf of the branch. So it was branch which was supposed to be charged with these expenses, but expenses were incurred by the head office. So head office will recover those expenses. So profit or loss account of head office will increase on account of recovery of this expense. And branch account will be debited to recover the expense. Goods sent by head office to branch 25,000 because goods have been sent by branch, no entry by head office. Correct? Similarly, we have 6.8. In this question, it is written, a remittance of past entries in the books of head office. Once again, entries in the books of head office is being asked. A remittance of 35,000 made by branch to head office on 29th of March 2022, received by the head office on 5th of April. So head office will pass a very simple entry, cash in transit account debit to branch account. Goods of 63,000 sent by head office to branch on 26th of March 2022. And received by the later on 4th of April 2022. There is no need to pass the entry in the books of head office, honestly speaking. However, branch will pass the entry goods in transit account debit to head office account. However, if you want to show this in the books of head office, you can still write goods in transit to branch account. And so many times we have done this one. Branch paid 30,000 as salary to a visiting official. Now, visiting official is of head office. So, head office was supposed to pay the salary. So, now head office will not pay the salary, but it will reduce its profit and loss account. Because this amount of salary is supposed to be now payable to the branch. So, branch account will be credited. So, that is why profit and loss account of head office will reduce and branch account will be credited. Now 6.9, all these questions have been taken from the past examinations, correct? Past general entry in the books of independent branch. Now this time, entries have been asked in the books of branch. You have to take care of this also in the examination. Income 2,800 allocated to the branch by head office. Actually, head office has allocated some income. Allocated income, not expense, to the branch. So, branch will pass the entry profit and loss account because when income will be allocated to the branch, the profit and loss account of branch will increase and branch will recover this from head office. So, branch will write entry head office account debit to profit and loss account. Provision for doubtful debts whose accounts are kept by head office not provided earlier for 1,000. Provision for doubtful whose accounts are kept by head office not provided for rupees 1,000. In this case, actually, head office will pass an entry provision for doubtful debts account debit due to which profit or loss account will get reduced. Right. Provision for doubtful debts whose accounts are kept by the head office. That means head office is maintaining the debtors balance of the branch. So similar to sometime actually head office takes the responsibility to maintain the accounts of fixed asset. Similar in this case, head office might be maintaining debtors account of the branch also. So provision for doubtful debts which were maintained by head office not provided rupees 1,000. So not provided rupees 1,000. So we will have to provide it. When head office will provide, the profit or loss account of head office will reduce, and of course the debtors balance will also reduce. But this amount head office will recover from branch. So in the books of head office, entry will be this, while in the books of branch office, entry will be profit and loss account debit to head office account. Because due to provision for doubtful debts which were provided by head office, branch is now supposed to pay to head office and it is a loss to branch. So that is why this entry will be passed. Let me check. Head office account will be credit, and provision for doubtful debts, instead you write profit and loss account. Write in bracket provision for doubtful debts account. Branch paid 3,000 as salary to head office manager. Now this expense is of head office, not of branch. Correct? So branch will recover this expense. Profit and loss account. And branch will recover this expense from head office. Write in bracket salaries. On account of salaries, we are going to recover this expense. Branch incurred traveling expense 5,000 on behalf of other branches. Our branch has incurred this traveling expenses of rupees 5,000. When we incurred 5,000 on traveling expenses, our profit and loss account must have got reduced. So we will recover the amounts, and when we will recover, our profit and loss account will increase, and we have to recover this account not from the other branches, rather from the head office. So that is why we will pass this entry. Remittance of 1,50,000 sent by branch office not received by head office. So no entry in this case because branch must have already passed the entry. Head office allocates 75 to the branch as head office expenses not recorded by the branch. When branch will record these expenses, profit and loss account of branch will get reduced and branch is supposed to pay these expenses to head office. Head office collected 30,000 directly from a branch customer. So branch customer has paid, so branch will credit the customer account, but amount is not received by branch, received by head office. So this is the entry branch will pass. So these are some questions which you must do, and with that we have come to the end of section 6 also. So you must have noticed that under section 6 actually, basically there are some adjustment question and sometime 2, 3, 4 mark question strike in the examination, and you should be then ready to face such question. I hope so. After having gone through this particular topic, you must have developed some confidence to tackle questions of such veracity. Now in the next session when we'll meet, we'll take section 7, inter-branch adjustment. This is also an interesting topic, however not very tough. Seems very tough, not very tough. And then finally we will reach the end of this chapter, that is towards section 8, correct? So in the next session we'll talk about first inter-branches, inter-branch adjustments, but that will be in the next session. Till then it's time to say goodbye.